I never saw children who ate and ate and ate until you finally had to cut them off and said you are done. How to check if your child is obese? Obesity rates are higher in adults than in children, but in relative terms, the United States, Brazil, China, and other countries have seen the problem escalate more rapidly in children than in adults. Almost one-third of children and adolescents in the United States and Russian Federation are overweight or obese. In the United Kingdom, obesity estimated to affect around 1 in every 5 children aged 10 to 11. To check if your child is a healthy weight, overweight or obese, you can use Body Mass Index, BMI. For children and young people aged 2 to 18, the BMI calculator takes into account age and gender, as well as height and weight. In the United Kingdom, the BMI calculator works out if a child or young person is underweight on the second centile or below, healthy weight between the second and 91st centiles, overweight 91st centile or above, obese 98th centile or above. A child's BMI is expressed as centile to show how their BMI compares with children who took part in national service. For example, a girl on the 75th centile is heavier than 75 out of 100 other girls her age. Let's take a look at the BMI Healthy Weight Calculator from the National Health Service. We choose child, 110 cm, 26 kilos. You can easily switch on pounds and inches if you need it. Child BMI is age and gender specific, so that we sign the date of birth the 18th of March 2012 and sex female. Even a month or two can make a difference to a child's BMI. That's why it's better to use to-date measurement of your child. Press calculate. The result is 97th centile. Your child's height and weight suggest she is overweight, and you should have a conversation with a pediatrician or other healthcare provider. The BMI-for-age percentile growth charts are the most commonly used indicator to measure the size and growth patterns of children and teens in the United States. BMI-for-age weight status categories are a bit more different from the United Kingdom. Underweight less than the 5th percentile, normal or healthy weight 5th percentile to less than the 85th percentile, overweight 85th to less than 95th percentile, obese equal to or greater than 95th percentile. Obesity is defined as a BMI at or above the 95th percentile for children and teens of the same age and sex. For example, a 10-year-old boy of average height 56 inches who weighs 102 pounds would have a BMI of 23. This would place the boy in the 95th percentile for BMI and he would be considered to have obesity. This means that the child's BMI is greater than the BMI of 95% of 10-year-old boys in the reference population. However, this simple and fast method has several limitations. The first limitation, the BMI cannot be used for children less than 2 years of age. How to deal with this? For children less than 2 years of age, consult the WHO Child Growth Standards or CDC Clinical Growth Charts. These standards take into account weight, height, age and gender, as well as head circumference and the ratio of these indicators. You can find out all the links below this video. The second limitation, the BMI cannot tell the difference between excess fat, muscle or bone. If children have a high BMI for their age and sex, a healthcare provider may perform further assessments to determine if excess fat is a problem. These assessments might include skin fold thickness measurements, evaluation of a diet, physical activity, family history, and other appropriate health screenings. The third limitation, if you have an eating disorder, the BMI calculator results do not apply. Anyway, if your child has a medical condition or you have questions or concerns about their health, please get further advice from your doctor. Childhood obesity has been called one of the most serious public health challenges of the 21st century, and with good reason. Obesity can harm nearly every system in a child's body: heart and lungs, muscles and bones, kidneys and digestive tract, as well as the hormones that control blood sugar and puberty, and can also take a heavy social and emotional toll. What's worse, youth who are overweight or obese have substantially higher odds of remaining overweight or obese into adulthood, increasing their risk of disease and disability later in life. Infants and preschool children intrinsically adjust their food consumption over a period of a day to take in a consistent number of calories. This is known as compensation. Give a preschooler food that is more energy dense than usual, and the child will compensate by subsequently eating less of other foods. But that self-regulatory system is changing. Susan Johnson, who directs the Children's Eating Laboratory at the University of Colorado Health Sciences Center, said that in the 1980s, children aged 2 to 4 were compensating for about 90% of any extra calories added to their diet. By the 1990s, they were compensating for only about 45% of those added calories. Johnson found that school-age children compensate to some degree, but not fully, and their capacity to compensate declined with age, year after year, especially among girls. The older they got, the less they compensated. I never saw children who ate and ate and ate until you finally had to cut them off and said, "You are done. They are eating to excess now," said Johnson. So what should be done to help children achieve a healthy weight and to avoid obesity? We will discuss in the next video. Take care of your body, mind, and your children. See you.